Welcome to Gujarat Literature Festival 2016. I am your host Lippy Goyal. Well, abhi bahut hi do interesting log yahan stage pe aane wale hain who are going to talk on the topic around the world in 30 months. It's going to be about foreign policies and let's see what they have over here to share. I would like to invite the first guest over here. Apart from being my mentor, well, she is a graduate from IIM Calcutta 97 batch, masters in psychic from University of Atlanta. A columnist with DNA and Dainik Bhaskar, and a consultant and coach. I would like to invite Rama Moondra on stage for the session with a huge round of applause. Yes, it's a post-lunch session, so there shouldn't be a problem with clappings over here right now. And she will be interacting with our next guest. A few lines about him. Dr. Vijay is in charge of Overseas Friends BJP and Foreign Affairs Bharatiya Janata Party since November 2014. Before actively joining politics, he worked in senior management role in pharmaceutical research and development for 18 years. His last role being president in Torrent Pharmaceuticals Ahmedabad. Dr. Vijay is a PhD in microbiology from University of Pune, India, with 4 years of experience as a postdoctoral fellow at National Institutes of Health USA. He has attended executive management program at IIM Bangalore and leadership development program at London School of Business. I would like to now invite him on stage for his next session with a huge round of applause. And we'll be talking about around the world in 30 months. All about foreign policies, and I hope it's an interesting session. And later, the platform will be open for Q&A. Please enjoy, and a warm welcome once again. Thank you so much.
Good afternoon. So once again, very good afternoon. He is making me speak 3 times क्योंकि मुझे आप लोगों से गुड आफ्टरनून की विश नहीं मिली अभी तक. थैंक यू सो मच. विजय भाई अपने अहमदाबादी रहे हैं, दिल्ली जाने से पहले उनको लगना चाहिए कि अहमदाबाद उनका शहर है आज भी. सो कैन वी डू वन मोर राउंड ऑफ अपलॉज अगेन. थैंक यू सो मच. सो यू हर्ड अबाउट हिज सीवी, यू हर्ड अबाउट व्हाट ही डज. हम इंडिया की फॉरेन पॉलिसीज़ के बारे में थोड़ा डिस्कस करेंगे, थोड़ा सा आप उनसे जानने की कोशिश करेंगे कि हमारे ऑनरेबल पीएम के बारे में और कुछ और नई पुरानी बातें. एंड वी डेफिनेटली विल हैव द प्लेस ओपन आल्सो फॉर योर क्वेश्चंस. सो विजय भाई, थैंक यू सो मच फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फॉर एक्सेप्टिंग आर इन्विटेशन एंड बींग एट GLF. सबसे पहले तो मुझे आपसे ये पूछना था कि मोदी डॉक्ट्रिन है क्या, व्हाट एग्जैक्टली मोदी डॉक्ट्रिन इज.
सो मोदी जी आने के बाद 2 साल के समय हुआ था, तब सम ऑफ अस थॉट दैट वी शुड रिव्यू व्हाट ही हैज बीन डूइंग इन फॉरेन पॉलिसी. और उससे एक किताब का जेनेसिस हुआ है. द नेम इज़ द मोदी डॉक्ट्रिन न्यू पैराडाइम इन इंडियाज फॉरेन पॉलिसी विच इज़ ऑफ विच आई एम वन ऑफ द को एडिटर्स. सो आई वुड से दैट मोदी डॉक्ट्रिन इज, इवन दो वी हैव गिवन द नेम, इट इज़ स्टिल अ डॉक्ट्रिन इन इमर्जिंग डॉक्ट्रिन. और उसके बट देर आर सम 5 or 6 सिलियंट फीचर्स विच वी कैन इजीली टॉक. वन इज ऑफकोर्स यू हैव सीन वेरी रिसेंटली व्हेन आवर फोर्सेस हैज क्रॉस द बॉर्डर, व्हाट इज कॉल्ड इज नाउ सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक्स. एंड जो अपना एक हेजिटेशंस था, रिस्ट्रेंट था, जिसको हम स्ट्रेटेजिक रिस्ट्रेंट कहते थे, that strategic restraint we have overcome. But in addition to this, which is a very unique thing about Modi's foreign policy, but there are some 5 or 6 features. I will quickly touch upon them and then we can go ahead. First is definitely there is now a very tight integration of India's domestic policies and foreign policy. That means India's domestic flagship programs like Digital India, Make in India, or even social flagship program like Swachh Bharat, they are now also becoming a part of foreign policy. The second aspect ये है कि जो अपने कुछ hesitations थे पहले कि भाई ये देश से जरा दूर रहना, for example Israel से दूर रहना क्योंकि अपना अरब वर्ल्ड के साथ they may get offended, or back home or minority voters will not vote for us. ऐसे सब हेजिटेशन सभी दूर हो गए एंड वी आर डीलिंग विथ वेरी कॉन्फ्लिक्टिंग कंट्रीज इन इक्वल टर्म्स. टू गिव यू एग्जाम्पल, सऊदी अरेबिया और ईरान राइट नाउ दे आर इन पोल्स अपार्ट, बट वी आर हैविंग गुड रिलेशनशिप विद बोथ द अरब कंट्रीज एंड एट द सेम टाइम वी आर डेवलपिंग वन ऑफ द एक्सलेंट रिलेशनशिप विद इज़राइल. तीसरा है कि हमने सिविलाइजेशनल कनेक्ट, जिसको हम बोल सकते हैं कि विच इज़ एसेंशियली कनेक्टिंग द अवर ओल्ड सिविलाइजेशनल बॉन्ड्स लाइक इन मंगोलिया, इन म्यांमार, कंबोडिया, फिजी, श्रीलंका, ऑल दी कंट्रीज के साथ कभी भी ऐसा हुआ नहीं था कि इतने अच्छे संबंध है. और एक बात है कि डायस्पोरा का जो इन्वॉल्वमेंट है, यू हैव सीन ऑल दिस बिग इवेंट्स विथ प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी एंड आई वॉज फॉर्चुनेट टू अटेंड ऑलमोस्ट ऑल ऑफ देम. ये भी एक बहुत यूनिक पर्सपेक्टिव है. और लास्ट और सबसे बड़ा ये है कि इंडिया ने एक लीडरशिप रोल आज दुनिया को दिया है इन वेरियस आस्पेक्ट्स, कि जो पहले कभी नहीं था. एनवायरनमेंट समिट फ्रांस में जो ही, जिसमें सोलार अलायंस की बात की गई, विच वॉज प्रपोज बाई इंडिया, योगा डे वॉज प्रपोज बाई इंडिया. सो वी आर यूजिंग ऑल अवर सॉफ्ट पावर स्किल्स टू ब्रिंग इंडियाज लीडरशिप टू द वर्ल्ड फोरम. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द salient features of emerging Modi doctrine. That much I will say.
Great. जब हमारे ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर ने गद्दी ली और उसके बाद उन्होंने एशियन कंट्रीज की बहुत ट्रैवलिंग की, और जब हम इसके बारे में पढ़ते थे तो लोग कहते थे लुक ईस्ट पॉलिसी है ये. व्हाट इज लुक ईस्ट पॉलिसी इसके बारे में?
इनफैक्ट नाउ वी हैव गॉन अ स्टेप अहेड एंड वी आर सेइंग इट्स नॉट ओनली लुक ईस्ट बट ऑल्सो एक्ट ईस्ट. और आप देखिए तो मोदी जी हैज कवर्ड ऑलमोस्ट ऑल दिस पैसिफिक रिम कंट्रीज, वियतनाम, साउथ कोरिया, जापान, ऑफकोर्स देर इज नाउ एनुअल समिट, म्यांमार, फिजी एंड फिजियन आइलैंड कंट्रीज, ऑस्ट्रेलिया, न्यूजीलैंड अभी तक गए नहीं है बट. तो आई थिंक वी हैव क्वाइट कॉमन, वन इज वी हैव लॉट ऑफ कल्चरल वैल्यूज विच आर कॉमन, द वे वी आर कमिंग आउट विच इज नॉन वेस्टर्न जो अपना वर्ल्ड व्यू है वो भी कॉमन है. तो इस दृष्टि से देर आर लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स कॉमन इन एक्सचेंज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल राइट नाउ साउथ कोरिया मोबाइल टेक्नोलॉजी, एल जी प्लस सैमसंग इज कैप्चरिंग ह्यूज मार्केट इन इंडिया, जापान इज नाउ इन्वेस्टिंग इन बुलेट ट्रेन बिटवीन अहमदाबाद एंड मुंबई एंड बिग इन्वेस्टमेंट्स आर कमिंग फ्रॉम ईस्टर्न साइड. उसमें थोड़ा सा स्ट्रेटेजिक इश्यूज भी है कि इंक्रीजिंगली एग्रेसिव और मोस्ट एसर्टिव पोस्टरिंग ऑफ चाइना इज ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ दिस काउंटर दैट, हाउ टू काउंटर दैट इज ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ दिस एक्ट ईस्ट डिप्लोमेसी.
डिमोनेटाइजेशन से ज़्यादा भी एक और चीज़ ने लोगों की बहुत नींद उड़ाई थी थोड़ा टाइम पहले. ट्रंप बिकेम अमेरिकाज लीडिंग मैन एंड उसके बाद बहुत लोगों को ये फिक्र हो गई कि इंडिया और यूएस के अब रिलेशनशिप कैसे होंगे. व्हाट इज़ योर टेक ऑन दैट?
जस्ट कपल ऑफ डेज बिफोर इलेक्शंस इन यूएस आई रोट अ कॉलम इन इंडियन एक्सप्रेस. उसका टाइटल ऐसा था कि गुड लक हिलरी, गुड लक ट्रंप, इंडिया इज वॉचिंग यू. मेरा ऐसा मानना है कि इंडिया यूएस रिलेशंस अभी एक मैच्योरिटी लेवल पे गए हैं कि जो इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन दे विल रिमेन वेरी स्ट्रांग. थोड़ा सा पॉलिसीज में चेंज इधर उधर हो सकता है और होगा भी, एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन चेंज हो गई तो. और इफ़ यू सी द पास्ट, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है कि भाई सिर्फ डेमोक्रेटिक प्रेसिडेंट के साथ अपने अच्छे रिलेशंस रहे हैं या रिपब्लिकन के साथ. वी हैव गुड एंड बैड रिलेशंस. आई कैन गिव एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ बोथ द पार्टीज. दैट इज़ द हिस्टोरिकल पर्सपेक्टिव. ट्रंप ने फॉर एग्जाम्पल अभी पाकिस्तान के पीएम के साथ एक टेलीफोनिक वार्ता का, देर इज़ अ न्यूज़ वेयर ही हैज सेड दैट ही वुड लाइक टू इंटरवीन बिटवीन इंडिया पाकिस्तान कॉन्फ्लिक्ट. तो ये थोड़ी चिंता की बात होती है. वेन ही सेज दैट ही वुड लाइक टू स्टॉप इमिग्रेशन, स्किल्ड इमिग्रेशन, तो H-1B वीसा वाले अपने हजारों IT वालों का क्या होगा, ये भी एक चिंता का विषय है. बट ऑन द अदर साइड, अभी वेल सिटिंग हियर आई वॉज लुकिंग एट वन ऑफ द रिपोर्ट्स वेन ही वेंट टू फ्लोरिडा एंड praised Hindu community in a big way for supporting him and he said ki I would like to work with Prime Minister Modi. Abhi aaj ka report hai, when I was sitting here I just read it. Teesri baat aisi hai ki even during the campaign there was a coalition called as Hindu Republican Coalition, Republican Hindu Coalition, RNC. who have funded him by $1 million, और वहाँ जाके उन्होंने बहुत अच्छा प्रो इंडिया स्पीच दिया है. And not only that, he even said कि अब की बार ट्रंप सरकार, अब की बार मोदी सरकार का, he has made his own version. So the signals are mixed, but I am still confident that the relationship will go stronger. उसका एक aspect ये भी है कि American Congress का इंडिया को bipartisan support है. To give you a small example, इंडिया कॉकस जो है अमेरिकन कांग्रेस में, उसमें देर आर मोर देन 100 कांग्रेसमैन आर द मेंबर ऑफ दैट कॉकस, एंड दिस इज द सिंगल लार्जेस्ट वन कंट्री स्पेसिफिक कॉकस इन द एंटायर यूएस कांग्रेस. सो इट शोज दैट वी हैव अ बायपार्टिसन सपोर्ट, एंड देयरफॉर आई एम श्योर दैट द रिलेशनशिप विल मैच्योर फर्दर.
When you talked about good and bad relationship, तो एक आध bad relationship की मैं भी बात कर लूँ लगे हाथ. China के बारे में what is the foreign policy and what we are looking at?
I think China is definitely, we are entering into a very curious phase, and the relationship is complex to say the least. क्योंकि there are lot of trade is happening. In fact, India China is the biggest, one of the biggest trading partner, China. And we import a lot of raw material. I don't have to tell Gujarat how much raw material we import from China. So how much diamond trade happens between India and China, all these are the facts, and that trade is not reducing. In fact, it is growing. But after saying that, India ke do concerns hai. Ek to uska aur Pakistan ka jo abhi nexus ban raha hai, that is definitely a worrisome part for us. उन्होंने जो चाइना पाकिस्तान इकोनॉमिक कॉरिडोर बनाया है, दैट कैन बी थ्रेट टू अस टू एन एक्सटेंट, बिकॉज देन चाइना कम्स थ्रू द वेदर एयरपोर्ट. एंड जो साउथ चाइना सी में जो कॉन्फ्लिक्ट है, वहाँ जो उसके एग्रेसिव पोस्चरिंग है, दैट ऑल्सो कैन अफेक्ट अवर ट्रेड थ्रू पैसिफिक, बिकॉज लॉट ऑफ अवर ट्रेड गोज फ्रॉम दैट रूट. सो इफ देर इज एनी टेंशन इन दैट एरिया, वो हमको जरा चिंता का विषय हो सकता है. सो आई एम श्योर इट इज़ क्वाइट कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, एंड वी बोथ आर कम्पीटिंग ऑल्सो एंड वी आर कोऑपरेटिंग ऑल्सो. सो नाउ राइट नाउ इट्स अ फेज दैट द कॉम्पिटिशन इज टेकिंग प्रेसिडेंस ओवर द कोऑपरेशन, एंड दैट इज द करंट सिचुएशन इज रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ दिस आस्पेक्ट.
सो व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट बैड रिलेशनशिप, वन ऑफ आर एब्सोल्यूट नेबर कंट्री जिनका काम ये है कि मतलब हमारे यहाँ बारात में जितने पटाखे छूटते हैं उससे कम पटाखे वो लोग बॉर्डर पे छोड़ते हैं और उसके बाद जाके तालियां बजाते हैं. ये ड्रामा है, एक प्रॉपर चलता रहता है. बट बैड रिलेशनशिप फॉर ईयर्स, आई थिंक वी हैव एवर सिंस विद पार्टीशन वी हैव बीन हार्बरिंग बैड रिलेशनशिप. व्हाट्स इंडियाज़ फॉरेन पॉलिसी सेज अबाउट, एंड डू यू एवर सी पाकिस्तान ऑफकोर्स, एंड डू यू एवर सी दैट पाकिस्तान के साथ हमारे रिलेशनशिप कभी भी थोड़े बहुत भी नॉर्मल होने के चांसेस हैं?
नॉर्मल की डेफिनेशन हमको पहले करनी पड़ेगी एज फार एज पाकिस्तान इज कंसर्न, एंड दैट नॉर्मल डेफिनेशन ऑफ नॉर्मल चेंजेस विद द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑन अदर साइड. ये गवर्नमेंट ने ऐसा कहा है कि वी विल टॉक विद पाकिस्तान अबाउट टेररिज्म, एंड टेररिज्म एंड टॉक्स कैनॉट गो टुगेदर. सो इन दैट रिस्पेक्ट वी डिड सम एफर्ट्स, वी वॉक्ड एक्स्ट्रा माइल व्हेन प्राइम मिनिस्टर हिमसेल्फ वेंट टू पाकिस्तान, वी इन्वाइटेड देयर डेलीगेशंस टू इंडिया एटसेट्रा, सो दैट देर इज सम discussion continues as far as cross-border terrorism is concerned. But it didn't work, that's a fact. And therefore, unless Pakistan decides that we are not going to support terrorism, or terrorism is not an extended arm of our foreign and defense policy, I don't see a lot of things to progress between India and Pakistan. And therefore, I feel that the ball is squarely on the Pakistan's court about what kind of relations they would like to have with India.
Totally. And when we're talking about good and bad, one good relationship that I would love to know your view on, Brexit, what is the opinion and how do you think it's going to shape up?
Coincidentally, I just spent almost 10 days in London, in fact 20th to 30th November. So, as if we sit here in any corner of tea restaurant anywhere in France, within 5 minutes we start talking about demonetization. In England, if you sit anywhere in 5 minutes you start talking about Brexit. And everyone, even in UK, is quite uncertain about it. Hindu, in fact, the Hindu newspaper, in fact, has published a story on my name, which is correct story, where I said that no one is sure how is Brexit is emerging. And therefore, in 2 years period, post March 17, is the minimum time frame we are talking, and it may extend. So, dhai saal mein kya hoga, ye humko pata nahi hai. Aur dusra aisa hai ki world doesn't stop. So we will continue to have our relationship with other European countries. For example, we have very good relations with Germany. In fact, our trade with Germany is much higher than that of UK. We have very good relationship with France. So we will continue to build our relationship with rest of the Europe, while we don't know what kind of relationship it will emerge with the UK, because what policies they are going to have post-Brexit. So again, it's a time of quite uncertainty, and we have to wait and watch.
There has been a Project Mausam which talks about Chinese naval policy thing. Any updates on that, and if there is anything that apart from Chinese, specific on Chinese naval policy, is India looking at anything on that?
I think country's policy cannot be specific to one country, or especially defense policy. We have to take everything into consideration. China's couple of ships have recently visited Pakistan, which again is something of our concern. And therefore, I am sure our defense experts are taking note of it and developing our own counter policies accordingly.
Vijay, one of personal question, if you give me liberty to ask. You have been a corporate person, a doctoral fellow, you have worked in the US, and you have been all your life an R&D person. What made you come in politics, and active politics for that matter?
That's even I don't know the answer, to be honest with you. Sometimes in life, accidents happen. I was here in Torrent, happily working here, never did any politics even at a ward level. And one day I was suddenly asked that, will you join 2014 campaign of Prime Minister Modi? And I said, it's a once in lifetime opportunity, because I know what's going to happen. So I took a sabbatical leave from my company and joined campaign. I spent 4 months in Delhi, and I was sitting in the BJP headquarters doing a lot of things which I never did before. And to be honest with you, after the election, in fact, very next day, I came back to Ahmedabad after 2 days after election victory and joined my company. And thought that, okay, it was a once good experience, we won, let's carry that joy forever and do our routine. But then suddenly someone asked me that, would you like to come to party? And my first question was essentially same, that I never had any experience in party politics. So, but they said, they convinced me, and then I thought that, okay, let me take another plunge. So it's more an accident than any design.
I'm sure it's a good one, actually.
Yeah, it's a good accident.
विजय भाई, हमारे सेशन का टॉपिक है 30 दिवस मा दुनियानु भ्रमण. तो अराउंड द वर्ल्ड इन 30 मंथ्स अराउंड द वर्ल्ड इन 30 मंथ्स. ऑब्वियसली इट इज़ फॉर आर ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर. तो जब शुरू हुआ उनका, इतनी सारी ट्रिप शुरू हुई, एक बहुत, आई थिंक जहाँ पर भी बात चलती थी, एक बड़ा जोक का माहौल चलता था कि इंडिया में तो प्राइम मिनिस्टर होते ही नहीं हैं, और वो यू नो फ्री में घूमते रहते हैं, और ऐसे ऐसे भी जोक्स थे दैट या प्राइम मिनिस्टर को मिलना है तो देखो कि कौन सी कंट्री में, और वहाँ का टिकट कटाओ. डू यू थिंक दैट आफ्टर 30 मंथ्स हैज़ इट पेड इंडिया इन डिफरेंट वे, वन, एंड सेकेंड, वॉज इट अ पोलिटिकल मूव टोटली? आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू अंडरस्टैंड, वॉज इट अ ब्रांड इंडिया एक्सरसाइज और वॉज इट अ पोलिटिकल मूव?
आई थिंक इट्स अ मिक्स ऑफ बोथ. See, statistically speaking, the first year, the number of days Prime Minister was out vis-a-vis first year of Mr. Manmohan Singh was out of this country. The number of days actually are same, or maybe Manmohan Singh was out for more number of days, maybe a couple of days, 57 versus 59, something like that. So let us not go into the number game, but the fact is that any new Prime Minister tries to invest in the foreign policy in the early part of his tenure, because foreign policy is not something which gives result immediately. So naturally, you all know that where the journey is very long, you have to start early. So then that is precisely has happened. That is number one. Second is that why Modi got more visibility than his predecessors. because there were countries where India has not visited for several decades. I can give you example. After Indira Gandhi, and that too for a multilateral summit, no Indian Prime Minister visited Canada. No bilateral summit between India and Canada took place in some 25-27 years. Even our neighbor like UAE, where Dubai, every one of us might be going, but Indian Prime Minister never visited. So there were so many countries where India just simply has stopped interacting with them one-to-one. And therefore also it was a need that we go there and re-establish this relation. And I can give you examples after examples. That is number. Third part, what is the benefit we got? There are three parts. I will give you very quick things. One is that the FDI has gone up by 50% in last 2 years. And the large credit, Lion's credit can go to Prime Minister Modi's visit. Second, when you test the success of foreign policy, that when you are in crisis, when we did the surgical strike, not even one, except Pakistan itself, himself, no other country has raised voice against India. You give me one example. And that is the success of all this. So when we count not on the number of days, but what tangible benefits we got, and I think in that respect, we have achieved significantly.
I agree. There's one important announcement. Is Lippy or any of the thing there? Yeah, you can do that. So, one thing that you have to do is people who are standing at the plaza and canteen, ask them to go to different sessions because there's a lot of crowd built up there. So, they need to make it that place. So, give us just 1 second. There's an important announcement for people, not for you guys, people who are standing on the plaza. So, there's a lot of crowd built up there.
Hello, yes. જે લોકો પાછળ ઊભા છે કેન્ટીનની આગળ અને આપણો જે રસ્તો છે ત્યાં, એ લોકોને વિનંતી કે તમે તમારા ગમતા સેશનમાં જઈને બેસો, કારણ કે ઘણા બધા ઇન્ટરેસ્ટિંગ સેશન ચાલી રહ્યા છે. અહીંયા પણ તમે આવીને બેસી શકો છો. અને સૌથી મેજર, બહાર જે લોકોની ગાડી હજુ પણ પડી છે, જે લોકોના ટુ વ્હીલર્સ ફોર વ્હીલર્સ, એ પ્લીઝ ત્યાંથી હટાવી લો, કારણ કે રોડની આ સાઈડ પોસિબિલિટી છે કે તમારું વ્હીકલ ટોઈંગ થઈ જાય. તો પ્લીઝ તમે જાઓ, જેનું પણ વ્હીકલ બહાર હોય તમે જાઓ ફટાફટ એને હટાવીને સામેની સાઈડ અથવા આ જમણી બાજુ જે જગ્યા છે ત્યાં મૂકી દો, અને પછી કોઈ પણ સેશનમાં જ્યાં પણ તમે બેઠા છો ત્યાં બેસો. ઇટ્સ વેરી ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ, જેનું પણ વ્હીકલ બહાર હોય પ્લીઝ 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 એને ત્યાંથી હટાવી લો. થેન્ક યુ રમા, થેન્ક યુ.
સો મૂવિંગ ઓન ટુ વન મોર ક્વેશ્ચન. અ લોટ ઓફ યુથ એકચ્યુઅલી લુક ફોરવર્ડ ટુ પોલિટિક્સ એઝ એન અસ્પાયરિંગ કરિયર, રાઈટ? बट एक बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग चीज़ होती है, और मैंने कैंपेन में जब काम किया तब दो चार लोगों से जब भी बात होती, बहुत लोग जेन्युइनली हेल्प करने आए, पर बहुत लोगों के साथ ये भी हुआ कि मैम आप अगर पॉलिटिक्स में कुछ बनो ना तो याद रखना. मैंने कहा मैं तो कभी एक्टिव पॉलिटिक्स में जाने नहीं वाली हूँ, मैं सिर्फ इसलिए कर रही हूँ कि मुझे लगता है कि कंट्री को एक बेटर लीडर चाहिए. और मिलियंस ऑफ पीपल फॉर दैट मैटर अक्रॉस इंडिया वर्कड हार्ड फॉर कैंपेन ओनली बिकॉज इट वॉज अ पीपल्स कैंपेन, दे मेड इट देयर ओन कैंपेन. सो पॉलिटिक्स के साथ ये एक एसोसिएशन क्यों है कि लोगों को लगता है कि इसमें इसलिए आना चाहिए कि इसमें बहुत पैसा है?
एटलीस्ट आई हैव नॉट सीन इट सो फार, बट जोक्स अपार्ट, एवरीथिंग इन पॉलिटिक्स इज नॉट बैड. देर आर लॉट ऑफ वेरी गुड पीपल हु आर इन पॉलिटिक्स एंड दे आर रियली वर्किंग फॉर ओवरऑल, नॉट फॉर देयर ओन बेनिफिट. एंड दे आर, आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट दे आर ओनली इन बीजेपी, दे आर देयर इन ऑल द पार्टीज. And there are some corrupt people also, and there are many corrupt people who are not in the politics. So you don't have to brand or castigate politics in one way or other. I feel that the good people, learned people need to go to politics, or at least become politically active or become aware of what's happening around them, and then only they can ask pertinent questions. A lot of our today's opinion is influenced by what we listen in on TV in the evening, and most of the time you get only one-sided stories. Either I am not saying pro or anti BJP, but again you get only one-sided view. So unless we go in depth, we understand what's the dynamics of everything, I don't think we can become a better citizen. And at least for that, political awareness is very important.
सो अगर किसी को पॉलिटिक्स में हेल्प करनी है, वॉलंटियर करना है लेकिन एक्टिव पॉलिटिक्स में नहीं जाना है, और यूथ जो हमारी नेशन बिल्डिंग का सबसे बड़ा हिस्सा बनते हैं, व्हाट शुड बी वे आउट फॉर देम? हाउ कैन दे बी अ पार्ट ऑफ नेशन बिल्डिंग अकॉर्डिंग टू यू?
आई थिंक मींस नॉट अ पॉलिटिक्स बट इफ यू सी ओवरऑल गवर्नेंस, देर इज अ वेरी गुड प्लेटफॉर्म कॉल्ड mygov.in which is you can have an app also, mygov app, which is a platform for the participatory governance, and there are already 20 lakh registered users on this platform, and you can suggest, give a lot of suggestions about governance, about policy. You can participate in various activities of the government and be an active contributor to this. So I guess this can be a very good starting point for if you are really interested to do something for the country.
Great. Vijay, we'll open the forum for our audience now to question answer. Is there somebody, our volunteers are there for with mic? And meanwhile, I'll take a second to acknowledge our next speaker, Dr. Anita Karwal, who has been very, very courteous and very polite guest to sit through the whole session. Ma'am, we are running a little overboard with the time, but thank you so much.
Hello. मैं आपसे क्वेश्चन करना चाहता हूँ कि हमारी फॉरेन पॉलिसी जो हो रही है और अभी मोदी जी जा रहे हैं, तो इससे क्या देश की माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक प्लानिंग होगी या फिर मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक प्लानिंग होगी? क्योंकि हर पॉलिटिक्स पार्टी चाहती है कि 5 ईयर्स में उनका बड़े से बड़ा इन्वेस्टमेंट दिखे या फिर बड़े से बड़ी चीज़ दिखे, जो हम मैक्रो प्लानिंग कहते हैं, पर इससे क्या माइक्रो प्लानिंग होगी? और जो बेसिस प्लानिंग अभी हमारे यहाँ इतनी स्ट्रॉन्ग नहीं है, तो उसमें कुछ बदलाव आ रहा है या फिर फॉरेन करेंसी आएगी तो उससे माइक्रो प्लानिंग में या फिर माइक्रो लेवल पे कुछ बदलाव होगा क्या?
इसलिए ऐसा है कि फॉरेन पॉलिसी डेफिनेटली, ट्रेड एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट इज वन पार्ट ऑफ द एनी फॉरेन पॉलिसी, बट इट इज़ नॉट द ओनली वन. और हर कंट्री में जाने के लिए एक ही ऑब्जेक्टिव होता ऐसा नहीं है, हर एक कंट्री में जाने के लिए देयर आर डिफरेंट ऑब्जेक्टिव. अल्टीमेटली फॉरेनर इन्वेस्टमेंट्स ओनली कैन डू अप टू अ मार्क, अप टू एन एक्सटेंट. अल्टीमेटली तो हमको ही जो करना है वही करना है. इसलिए ब्रॉड एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन, ग्रोथ ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स विल डिपेंड ऑन हाउ अवर कंट्री परफॉर्म देन बींग डिपेंडेंट ऑन अदर कंट्री.
हेलो, मेरा सवाल है कि जब प्रेसिडेंट साई जो है ताइवान के नए प्रेसिडेंट, तो वहाँ पे फ्रॉम इंडिया देयर वर मेनी एमपीज वर गोइंग फॉर हर इनॉग्रेशन, तो अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ चाइना नरेंद्र मोदी टर्न डाउन द रिक्वेस्ट ऑफ द मेनी एमपीज. ओनली 3 पीपल वेंट देयर, यू, प्रोफेसर नालापत एंड ताइवान एम्बेसडर टू इंडिया. सो इज इट लाइक वी आर अंडर इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ द चाइना, मीन्स अवर फॉरेन पॉलिसी स्टिल अंडर इन्फ्लुएंस, वेर एज द न्यू प्रेसिडेंट इलेक्ट ट्रंप हैज कॉल्ड डायरेक्ट टू द दैट particular lady. So what is happening? Forget the war or something, but we are deciding this policy ke kis kon jayega kon nahi jayega. So what is happening?
See, first of all, I didn't go to Taiwan. That is number one clarification. Others who have gone are non-political people. We have a one China policy. That means politically we recognize only one China, which is of which the capital is Beijing. That is number one. But at the same time, we have even in the mission in Delhi of Taiwan is not called as a embassy of Taiwan. It is called as a trade and cultural representative of Taiwan. So per se, we are not diplomatically connected with Taiwan. And that is also, but at the same time, we have very good and expanding trade relationships. So commercial negotiations always happen and exchange of views also always happen. But diplomatically, we are still little bit away from recognizing, not little bit, far away from recognizing Taiwan as a independent country.
गुड आफ्टरनून सर, माई सर डॉक्टर जय चौधरी. मोदी जी ने जो बलूचिस्तान पर बैन दिया था इंडिपेंडेंट डे पर, वो क्या सिर्फ पाकिस्तान के कश्मीर वाले मुंह को पैरालाइज करने के लिए था या फिर हमारे पास सही में प्लान है? और प्लान है तो क्या हम प्रोसीजर कर पाएंगे उस पर? धन्यवाद.
बलूचिस्तान में के दो इश्यूज है. वन इज दैट देर आर ह्यूमन राइट वॉयलेशंस इन बलूचिस्तान, और दूसरा है कि सेपरेट बलूचिस्तान की भी कोई लोग मांग कर रहे हैं। हमने जो बात की है गवर्नमेंट लेवल पे वो सिर्फ ह्यूमन राइट वॉयलेशन की बात की है, नॉट अ सेपरेशन ऑफ बलूचिस्तान फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान, क्योंकि देयर इज अ डॉक्यूमेंटेड, वेरी वेल डॉक्यूमेंटेड एविडेंस दैट देयर आर स्टेट स्पॉन्सर और मिलिट्री स्पॉन्सर्ड किलिंग्स, रेप्स, एट्रोसिटीज ऑफ बलोच पीपल बाय पाकिस्तानी आर्मी एंड पाकिस्तानी एस्टेब्लिशमेंट। सो वी आर रेजिंग अ वॉइस एंड आई हैव मेड सेवरल बलोच लीडर्स हु आर नाउ इन एक्साइल इन वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड, इंक्लूडिंग इन लंडन एंड इन जर्मनी एंड ऑल्सो इन डेली, सम ऑफ देम हैव कम टू डेली एंड दे हैव हॉरिफाइंग स्टोरी, यू वुड नॉट स्लीप इफ यू लिसन टू देयर स्टोरीज एंड दे कैन शो द डॉक्यूमेंट्री एविडेंस विथ फोटोग्राफ्स एंड एवरीथिंग। सो दिस इज अ रियल इशू एंड इट इज़ वेरी एप्ट फॉर अस दैट व्हेन पाकिस्तान इज टॉकिंग सो मच अबाउट ह्यूमन राइट्स वायलेशन इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एंड रेस्ट ऑफ द कंट्री, वी नीड टू शो अ मिरर इन फ्रंट ऑफ पाकिस्तान एंड टेल देम एंड ऑल्सो टेल द वर्ल्ड व्हाट्स हैपनिंग इन देयर बैकयार्ड। सो दैट इज अवर स्ट्रेटेजी।
नमस्ते सर, माई सेल्फ रवि, विचार दी कैवियट्स टू गेट इंडिया इन टू NSG नेशनल सिक्योरिटी, आई मीन न्यूक्लियर सिक्योरिटी ग्रुप। थैंक यू।
यू नो दैट द NSG डिसीजन्स आर टेकन प्लेस ओनली बाय कंसेंसस एंड राइट नाउ चाइना इज नॉट विलिंग टू एक्सेड टू अवर रिक्वेस्ट, सो अनलेस चाइना एग्रीज इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर अस टू गो टू NSG।
हेलो सर, मैं राघवेंद्र यादव हूँ। मैं जानना चाहता था कि जो अभी रूलिंग पार्टी है सेंटर में, उनसे बार बार ये चीज़ मतलब अपील की जाती है कि हम चाइनीज प्रोडक्ट को जो है बहिष्कार करें, लेकिन जब सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट में मतलब सुषमा स्वराज जी चाइना जाते हैं तो जो उनका फर्स्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव होता है वो होता है कि हम पॉजिटिव जो है व्यापार करेंगे, तो फिर ये डाइवर्ट क्यों है, मतलब कि दोहरापन क्यों है कि जो गवर्नमेंट का जो एफर्ट है वो है कि हम मतलब पॉजिटिव व्यापार करेंगे, ट्रेड पॉजिटिव ट्रेड,
और ये दोनों कॉन्फ्लिक्टिंग नहीं है। सी व्हेन यू से यूज इंडियन बाय इंडियन इट डजंट मीन दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टॉप द इम्पोर्ट्स फ्रॉम चाइना नेक्स्ट डे, क्योंकि आज इतना इंटर डिसिप्लिनरी वर्ल्ड है कि फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई टेल यू, एक जो वही कंप्यूटर बनता है उसमें लिखा होगा शायद कि मेड इन चाइना और मेड इन ताइवान, बट उसमें जो कॉम्पोनेंट्स है वो एटलीस्ट 30-40 कंट्रीज में बने हुए रहते हैं। सो टूडेज वर्ल्ड एंड इकोनॉमी इज सो मच इंटरलिंक्ड। पुराने ज़माने में आई रिमेंबर व्हेन आई वाज इन US, वॉलमार्ट जो बड़ी चेन है वो एक कैंपेन किया था उन्होंने कि प्राउडली मैन्युफैक्चर्ड इन अमेरिका, तो कई सारे प्रोडक्ट्स पे ऐसे वो स्टिकर लगाते थे प्राउडली मैन्युफैक्चर्ड इन US। तो मैं जब था तो मैंने हमारे बॉस हु वाज अमेरिकन, सो शी सेड कि नाउ US ऑल्सो इज growing very well in the manufacturing sector and you must have seen this sticker on various American products. So I asked her jokingly, did you ever try to peel up that sticker and see the backside of it? So she said no. So I said backside of the sticker it is written printed in China, because America cannot afford to print that sticker in China. Many a times if they print in China, the cost of sticker would be more than the cost of the product. So right now world is so interlinked that it is virtually impossible to ban any country, especially the manufacturing giant like China, from our marketplace. But at the same time it doesn't mean that we should not propagate our own manufacturing units and encourage them to be competitive. So they are all parallel tracks, they are not one against the other.
Sir Jiten Bojani. Achha. Earlier there were only two superpower like Russia and America. Now, I mean, China has also emerged, India is emerging superpower, and Pakistan is at, I mean, strategic location. So, I mean, how equation are forming? Earlier, like we were with Russia, Pakistan were America. So even if we don't have a clear answer, but just wanted to know your view about this entire thing.
I think it's a multipolar world, which is very good for us. We don't have to dependent on one person or one nation for all our needs. For example, in past America simply refused to give us any defense related technology. Now they are jumping ahead of Russia to give us, and they are even offering us a lot of technologies which are available only to the NATO countries or their European allies. So it is a great success story. We have, it is like a mall for us. that we can go and pick up the choose rather than going only at one place and bound by whatever is available there. So we will do whatever best in our country irrespective of who is offering us. So it's a very interesting scenario.
Last two questions, please.
Sir, myself Nishit. What is your personal view on Kashmir issue?
Kashmir, see, there are two parts. Kashmir is an integral part of India and no one can deny it. And the whole story of accession of Kashmir and history, it is the chapter closed, no one can reopen it. But if there are some genuine grievances of Kashmiri people, we should address them. There are issues of employment, education, jobs, infrastructure. We should address them and we are addressing them. What's happening in current hesitation, which is a little worrisome, is that there is a strong influence of jihadi elements in the current agitation. And therefore the Hurriyat, which used to lead all the Kashmiri groups, are actually marginalized to a great extent. And this is taking a very new and quite worrisome turn, and that we should all be worried about.
Hello. Sir, Russia is natural partner of India from 1971 at least. But nowadays we have even Pakistan army have a training with Russia last month. So is it good for India?
See, one training, joint training exercise doesn't mean much. It is a kind of friendly training programs are happening all over the world. Only because it happened at the background of India-Pakistan tension, we got a note of it. It must have happened several times and we didn't take a note of it. Russia is still an important partner. But as I said, that because of the end of Cold War, we are not dependent only on Russia, for that matter, only on any other one country, and which is good for us. And as we are opening our space everywhere, Pakistan is also trying to do the same. So it's a game of chess. Each one will make its own move as per their interest.
Before we wind off, Vijay bhai, you have co-edited the book Modi Doctrine, and I understand now it's available on Kindle as well. Are you carrying a copy of the book so that we can show our people the book? So that's the book.
So this is the book. It is, I am one of the editors of three. Even though I belong to a party and other fellow also belong to BJP, this book is the contributors. There are 21 contributors. Except two of them, no one belonged to BJP. Even as a partial, to remain impartial, even I have not written a chapter in this. I just edited so that it is written by the people who are expert and career diplomats in the foreign policy. So all of them are foreign policy experts, journalists, ex-diplomats, retired ambassadors, not only from India but from other countries. For out of 21 contributors, 11 are from abroad. So this is a very credible reading. You may not agree to everything what is written there, but I am sure it will give a deep insight into foreign policy initiatives of Prime Minister Modi. It is available on Amazon, both in the, as a hard copy and also on Kindle. And after this surgical strike, we have come out with the next edition of it, and we added a specific chapter on the surgical strike in this.
Vijay bhai, last question before I wind off from me. How do you see India in coming 10 years as a country in terms of growth and in terms of foreign reputation, the reputation overseas, everywhere?
I think if we continue this path, definitely the future is very bright for us. India is gaining new respect. And at the time when all other countries are seem to be in a shaken ground, including Europe is in a uncertain, UK is definitely uncertain. After Trump, no one knows what's going to happen in US. Russia, we think that Russia is a very superpower, and it is superpower because of nuclear arsenal. But because of the weak oil prices, Russian economy is in a very bad shape. So in all these issues, India seems to be a very quite a bright spot, and if we continue to work in this direction, I do think that we will see a very bright future for all of us and for our next generation also.
And the second part of the question is, you have traveled a lot and you keep traveling a lot with our Honorable Prime Minister, and I have seen the massive part of event when I was in Canada fortunately, and even in South Africa. But for normal people, everyone around here, people would like to know that do you have a huge team who kind of travel across flights bharke or something like that? What exactly, how does this mega events work with a skeleton team or big team or whatever? Just one or two insights on that.
First of all, I don't travel with PM. I go in advance and then I stay there.
Right.
So I don't go in his plane.
I know.
Number two, I don't have a big team. We have a very small group in Delhi. But our view is that wherever Prime Minister's this big program which you see, the program is of the diaspora of that country and not of Delhi or me or BJP. So when I go there, I tell people that it is your program. It is not a program of BJP or our other platform called Overseas Friends of BJP, neither of Indian government nor of a foreign government. So it is your program. You are going to conduct it, you are going to organize it, and you are going to fund it. We don't fund any of this program from Delhi. So, and therefore leadership is also yours. It is very difficult sometimes, because all of you must have traveled abroad, and you must have seen that Indian diaspora is very divided. To give you a small example, in London city alone, forget about the rest of the UK, there are 650 Indian organizations. In Silicon Valley alone, there are close to 500, not in US, but Silicon Valley, San Francisco area alone, there are 500 community organizations, Indian community. So bring all of them is sometimes a task, but Prime Minister Modi has a lot of magnetism, so because on his name everyone comes, and when they come together then the chemistry develops. Of course there are some factions here and there, some frictions are there which I try to soothe on those, but mostly it is their program. I just tell them what to do and what not to do, that's it.
Thank you so much, Vijay bhai. Thank you so much for being with us. And Gujarat Literature Festival is really, really indebted to you. I would let Lippy take over.
Thank you so much, ma'am, and sir, for taking out time and being part of Gujarat Literature Festival. It was an absolute honor having them. And I hope you enjoy the festival today. Check. Friends, we'll just take a breather for 2 minutes before we start the next session. We are going to have an interesting session over here, and I would request all those who are attending the session and are there at the canteen and nearby, would request you to please come for the 4:15 session. Also, there is Irshad Kamil's show happening in the evening at 6:30 along with his band Vaz. So all of those who are interested can get your family members, friends and relatives for that session, the musical evening, not a session but a musical evening. You want to say something?
I hope તમે લોકો બહુ જ એન્જોય કરો છો, બહુ જ રસપ્રદ સંવાદો હવે પછી થવાના છે, થવા જઈ રહ્યા છે. પણ એક રિક્વેસ્ટ છે, પ્લીઝ આ દિલથી વિનંતીને સ્વીકારો. વચ્ચેના ભાગમાં, આ આખે આખા વેન્યુના વચ્ચેના ભાગમાં જેટલા પણ લોકો છે, એ લોકોને નમ્ર વિનંતી છે કે એ એમને ગમતા વેન્યુ ઉપર ગમતા સેશન્સમાં ગોઠવાય, એ જગ્યાને થોડી હળવી બનાવે. ત્યાંથી તમે સાંભળો છો, વાતો કરો છો, મજા કરો છો, અમને એનો આનંદ છે. પણ કેટલીક વ્યવસ્થાકીય ભાગની વિનંતી સ્વરૂપે અમે તમને કહીએ છીએ કે આપ આપનું સ્થાન ગોઠવી લો, મેળવી લો. આપ જ્યાં પણ જવા માગતા હોય એ તરફ પ્રસ્થાન કરશો તો અમને આનંદ થશે. એ જગ્યાને થોડી વેકેન્ટ કરવા માટે નમ્ર અરજ છે, ખાસ જે ત્યાં આગળ વચ્ચોવચ્ચ ઊભા છે અને કંઈ જ નથી કરતા.